Today we're going to talk about the smart ramps and how to install a servo. So there's a couple things we need to know. First of all, we have three pins here. We have our VCC, our 5 volt, or a 3.3 volt in this case, and then we have our ground. In order to power the 3 volts on here, we have to jump the 3 volts to or from the VCC. So what will happen now is current will travel up through here and over to this pin. So this is our 3 volt rail right here. Then we have our ground rail right here, and then we have our digital pins. Our digital pins are digital pin 11, then we have 6, digital pin 5, and digital pin 4. For this, we're going to use digital pin 11. So what we need to know about the servo is how to connect it. So the orange wire is going to be our signal, the red wire is going to be our voltage, and the brown wire is going to be our ground. So to connect this, what we need to do is take it over to here, line it up over the pins, and then just insert. So that's all you need to do to set it up for the mechanical side. Now we need to be able to load the firmware from Marlin. So we need to connect the small side of the USB to the programming port, and the big side to the computer, and you're going to hear a beep. In a moment, I'll show you how to load the Marlin firmware. Okay, the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to open up Marlin-bugfix-2.0.x. Then we're going to open up the Marlin subfolder. Then we're going to open up the source folder. And then we're going to open up the core folder. And inside the core folder, we're going to open up boards.h. And we're going to do a search on smart. And what we want to copy is board underscore ramps underscore smart underscore EFB. So we're going to make a copy of that. We're going to close out of this file. We're going to go up one file. Then we're going to go up another. Then we're going to click on the marlin.ino and open that up. Okay, what we're going to do now is select the configuration.h tab. We're going to do Control F, and we're going to do a search on motherboard. And we're going to replace board underscore ramps underscore 14 underscore EFB with what we just copied. So we're going to paste it here. And so now we have board underscore ramps underscore smart underscore EFB. Next thing we want to do is search on number of servos. So we're going to say num underscore servo. And currently it's commented out, so we're going to have to remove the comment by backspacing. And we're only working with one servo, so we're going to backspace over that. And we're going to say one servo. And then down below, we have the option to set the delay. Right now it's set to almost a third of a second, so 300 milliseconds. So the next thing we want to do is be able to load it with the firmware on the smart ramps. So we need to go over to board, and we need to find the actual setup for it, which is going to be Arduino Dua programming port. And we also have to make sure that we have the right port selected, which is going to be COM6 in this case. And then we're going to press the upload button, which will compile our changes and upload the firmware to the smart ramps board. So in a moment in Pronterface, I'll show you how to test it. Okay, we're in the Pronterface folder, so we're going to open up Pronterface. We're going to connect to the smart ramps board. And now to move the servo, we have to type M280 for a G code, P0 being the first servo. And in this case, we're going to say S0 because it's sitting at the 90 degree mark. And we're going to press enter and see what happens. Okay, so the servo moved to the zero position. So now we're going to try and move it to 180, which is the opposite direction. And we're going to press enter and see what happens. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.